These are signed by Jerry Killian.
Yes, they are. The first one says that Bush made no attempt to meet his training certification. That is a big difference than just missing his physical. And the second one refers to his pilot position as critical.
Oh, Bush said he stopped flying because they no longer needed pilots.
Mm-hmm. This document would prove that statement untrue.
Can you think of anybody who'd want to fool you with these, like a political dirty trick?
I can't think of anyone who would hate me that much.
And here's mine, Mia. I want you to live. I want that more than anything in this world. I want you to fight like hell to stay with us. But with everybody else gone, I know it might not be what you want. It might be too hard for you to keep fighting, so. If you want to go, I want you to know it's okay. It's okay. I understand.
Dear Lord, we pray that you will watch over and always shine your light on our humble servant, George W. Bush. In Jesus' name, amen.
There's an accident on the 520, so better take the 405. I used to be a cop, and there's never speed traps there. Trust me, you can do 100.
Yep, that'll stop all the accidents.
I'm just saying, I knew a guy who got a hand job doing 120 on the 405. And he just might be in this copter.
Maybe that's enough for the traffic. On behalf of Jim, the Channel 10 AccuNews team, this is Heidi Lopez Barrancas.
Hey, Heidi, how come when you say your name, you get all Spanishy? You never hear an Irish anchorman say, "This is Jimmy McCarthy, reporting to you from the Potato News Network, investigating who stole me Lucky Charms, eh?"
Are you Harry Bergeron?
Depends who's asking.
We are.
Who's we?
Depends who's asking.
I am.
Who's I?
Depends who's asking.
Alex, we need to talk.
One moment. I'm going to check on my baby back.
Those hickory smoked?
You know your ribs. Of course, it takes a great rack to know one.
I think we should see other people.
You in the middle? Just want you to just button up. Thank you. Just all the way.
And then one day you didn't show up, so I took over.
Oh, and then one day I showed up, so you can leave. I'm confused. Who's teaching the class now?
Now you see what you've done? You've broken the cardinal rule of acting. You've confused the hot guy.
Damn, those fellas do look happy.
Probably because in California they can't get married.
Really, really happy.
Saturday night's all right.
It was a business model of fraud.
For greed.
That's amazing what you learn after it's too late.
It's a Saturday night American Greed Marathon. Tonight, starting at 7 Eastern, CNBC. Get yours.
When did we get so soft? You know what this country used to sit on?
Logs, girders, poles. Being comfortable? That's not what America's all about.
Couch down. Sit down or get out of the way.
Homer, now listen to me. You're in a stadium surrounded by people who want to kill you.
They don't have the guts. Oh.
Now, there's one way out of your hell. Prove you still love beer. Drink this with gusto.
But the chip!
It was supposed to be a routine patrol. A milk run.
Look, Skipper. Enemy ship, 2 o'clock low, 2 miles. Easy pickings. What do you say?
Negative, Jigsaw 2. Our orders are to recon and report back.
Come on, Skip. It'll be a turkey shoot.
Let's do it, Skipper.
Yeah, come on.
All right. Let's go in for a closer look. But keep your distance.
Your invitation surprised me, Mrs. Lord. Your husband had no criminal associations. Believe me, I tried.
I got back from Vietnam. And Hollywood was out of control. Well, so was I. I tried working as a stuntman, but was too violent to be around normal folks. You understand? That crazy kike was working on a picture with the Hell's Angels, and a fight broke out, and I fucked up a couple of them, and Ezra, he saw that, and he gave me his car. That was that.
Right now, the nights are ours. But what happens if they decide that they need less sleep? What happens if they decide to grow against their digital lullabies? What happens when they're not afraid of the dark?
What are you suggesting?
I think what's happening now is more than temporary anarchy. I think it's the start of a war. It's going to be a short but extremely nasty one. But what does one do in a war? One kills one's enemies.
Well, even with the guns we have, it'll be slow work.
We have a gasoline pump at our little motor pool. Gasoline may serve to end their lives.
Hold up. You want to napalm them?
We have a sprayer truck that we use to keep our playing fields very green.
Today on Jason Bourne, Treadstone, and Blackbriar.
Sourced how?
Unknown.
From Bourne? Is it possible?
Possible? We had Bourne 6 weeks ago in Moscow. He was on foot, wounded, with a full Cossack posse up his ass. Somehow he walked out of there. I've kind of lost my perspective on what's possible.
You sound tired, Ezra. I'd make more of an effort if I were you. You're the director of the Central Intelligence Agency of the United States of America, for God's sake. Act like it.
Man and this mystery woman, did they ask you to lie to us?
They didn't want me to say how I got the documents.
I see. And so that's why you misled us?
Yes. Your producer was pushing me to find out where I got the memos from.
I see. So then that's why you lied to us?
Yes. And I know it caused some some problem. Excuse me.
Yeah. Hey there, Davy boy. Make some room. How's it going, cowboy?
It was going fine.
Woody? Ed? Well, enough of this chit-chat. It's time to get down to business. Woody, I tried to tell your boy that you wouldn't mind using some of your winnings to even the score with your old pal, Ed.
Well, how much you need? I got a 20.
A 20? No. I was thinking more along the lines of, say, 10 grand.
Give him 10 grand, Dan.
I don't got it yet.
Woody, I always thought we was friends. Remember, I was the one that convinced you to stay with Kate. Oh, yeah, Davy. Your dad wanted to get a divorce because he was screwing some half-breed down at the reservation. He thought he was in love. Ain't that right, Woody?